Hey guys, in this video we're going to determine what is best, a derma roller or a derma pen. I've been using derma rollers for the past 3 years, so I'm very familiar with these. And if you're familiar with my channel, you know as well that I love derma rollers. But I've always wanted to try a derma pen as well. So I actually wrote to Dr. Pen on Instagram and asked if they wanted to sponsor this video. I told them about the plan to compare derma rollers with derma pens, and they were more than happy to send me an M8 derma pen, which is what I'm holding right here. So the box came with two cartridges, 16 needles per cartridge, a little user manual, a charger, and this guy as well. So the Derma Pen M8 is what I'll be using for this video. Really quickly before we begin, you press this to start it, right there, super easy. The bearing, the silver bearing, you can actually turn to decide what depth needles you want, so you can go anywhere from 0 to 2.5 millimeters. You just place on top of here, turn it, take that off, and there we go. So it's super easy. So you can also decide the speed on it by just clicking it, tapping it. You can go up to speed 6, very fast. And then by just holding that button again, you're just turning it off. Also, they sent me two serums. They sent me one hyaluronic acid serum, which I'll probably use on my face with my girlfriend. She loves these things. And then a hair growth serum, which I won't be using. It has root oil and tea tree oil. Thank you very much for sending me that, but as I want to go natural, I'm not going to use anything. So what I'm going to do is, first week I'm going to use a derma roller, second week I'm going to use the derma pen, and I'm going to look at 4 different things. I'm going to look at the experience of usage, how it is to actually use the product. I'm going to look at experience of effectiveness, so how quickly can I use the product to get the results that I want. Since we can't measure the effectiveness, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a timer, and I'm actually going to see how long it takes for me to complete one session, and then compare the two. Then we're gonna look at maintenance, how much maintenance is required for each product. And then lastly, we're gonna look at the product price. And is the difference in price justifiable? All right, perfect, let's get right into it. So let's start with the derma roller. So I'm gonna put on the stopwatch and let's go. I can say already, my trap is hurting so much from just standing like this, which is one of the things I find very annoying with the derma roller. All right, so that took me 9 minutes and you can see that it's a bit red. All right, let's spin forward to a week from now when I'm gonna do the derma pen and we'll see how that goes. All right guys, so it's been about a week now. Sorry, I have a little bit of a cold, but nothing that's gonna kill me. As you can see, I've grown my hair a little bit. I haven't shaved in a couple of days, so it's looking quite all right. I've actually never tried this one before. Here, let's go. So far, so good. It's a little bit hard to get used to, but I'll talk more about that later in the video. Alright, so that's me done. 7 minutes and 23 seconds. If you're enjoying this video so far, I would love it if you would subscribe to this channel, because I love having you here and I don't want you to miss other videos that I make. Alright, back to the video. Alright, so the moment of truth, derma roller versus derma pen. Let's jump right into it. So, experience of usage. What I really like with the derma roller is that when you apply it, it goes straight on to your scalp, okay? So when I apply it like this, the needles go straight down. It's not bent any direction. Unless you're really, really distracted when doing this and you kind of tilt it like that, you go with the needles straight down, which I really like because that's the purpose of it. So the way that it's designed, it makes it really hard to mess up at least that bit of the process. However, because it's a lot of manual labor when using one of these, and also having to apply pressure, it can be quite hard knowing exactly what you're supposed to do, because your strokes may not be perfectly straight, and the pressure that you apply may not be the same throughout your entire scalp, which obviously is gonna have some effect of the results. And what I really like with the derma pen is that it's super easy to use. And the weakness that I find in the derma roller is what the derma pen actually delivers on. These needles will go in and out all the time, so you don't actually have to apply any pressure, it does that by itself. So you actually just have to move it around, which makes it very ergonomic, so you don't have to move and apply pressure, because what that does with the Derma Roller, it actually gives me a lot of tightness in my traps. Whereas when I use the Derma Pen, what I noticed was I actually just move it around and I don't have to apply any pressure, so the tension here is a lot less. So it makes it a lot more ergonomic to use. However, one negative thing that I found with the Derma Pen, and it may be because I've only used the Derma Pen once and I'm not really used to how it works. You see the plastic cylinder around the cartridge? The idea is that you're supposed to press it straight on to the scalp or the skin. Because the surface of the head is not plane, it makes it quite difficult for the cartridge to constantly be pushed straight down onto the scalp. So I think I actually may have had it tilted a little bit. And when the needles come out and it's tilted, that may not be a good thing. So for me, that was one of the difficulties when using the Derma Pen. As I said, I'm not sure this is because of me being inexperienced with the Derma Pen, or that it's just hard to do on a non-plane surface. When it comes to the experience of effectiveness with the Derma Roller, it took less than 10 minutes to do my entire scalp. And if you watched my previous videos, I've told you guys that I go in four different directions. I go in a vertical line, a horizontal line, one diagonal line, and one other diagonal line. But here I actually only did three directions, so I skipped the fourth diagonal line. But it took less than 10 minutes and I actually managed to cover my entire scalp. So in terms of effectiveness, I think it went very fast. Comparing that with the Derma Pen actually was a little bit faster. But I have to be honest with you guys, I actually only used the Derma Pen around here, and around the crown region, because I know that my balding isn't as bad around here. So I kind of started out just using it up here just to try it, but actually just focused on my temples and the crown. I didn't cover as much surface area with the Derma Pen as I did with the Derma Roller. When it comes to maintenance of the Derma Roller, it's very simple. What you buy is what you get. So you actually only have to buy a Derma Roller, and the Derma Roller is all you need in order to use it. However, the downside with the Derma Roller is you're gonna have to switch it every 3 to 6 months. And in my experience, the more frequently, the better, because these needles, they wear out. On top of that, after each treatment, you will have to wash and clean your Derma Roller, which can be quite time consuming. Comparing that with the Derma Pen, you don't have to clean anything at all. Basically, when you're done, you just take out the cartridge and you just throw it away. And the next time you're gonna use your Derma Pen, you just apply a new cartridge straight out of the pack and you're good to go. But that also has a downside, because after each treatment, you're gonna have to replace it with a new cartridge. So you're constantly gonna have to be aware of how many cartridges you have left so that you don't find yourself in a position where you wanna use your Derma Pen and you don't have a new cartridge to use, because then you can't use it. However, I've read online that a lot of people using the Derma Pen actually reuse your cartridge 4 to 5 times by cleaning it the same way you would clean a Derma Roller, which means they're gonna be able to last you a longer period of time and you're not gonna find yourself in a position of panic because you don't have any cartridges left. This is not something that I recommend because I haven't done this myself, so I don't know if this actually works. But given that the Derma Roller can be reused for 3 to 6 months, I would imagine if you clean these needles and keep the hygiene of the needles well maintained, you would be able to reuse it at least a couple of times. Price of product. If we look at the Derma Roller, a Derma Roller is about $10 each. So if you want to replace it every 3 to 6 months, basically that's going to be an annual cost of between $20 and $40. And then we want to add the cleaning material as well, so we'll add another $20 on top of that, because as you can tell, you're going to have to use quite a lot in order to clean the Derma Roller. So we'll say $20 a year. So that's an annual cost of between $40 and $60 for the Derma Roller. And when it comes to the Derma Pen, I'm using the M8. This one cost $130, and one of these cartridges cost $2.25 as well. So let's say you use the Derma Pen once a week, 2.25 times 52 weeks in 1 year. That's gonna give us an annual cost of $117. So we have the initial investment, $130, and then we have on top of that, $117 annually, which is quite a lot of money. However, if we decide we want to use one of these cartridges 4 times, so for 4 sessions before we replace it, then we're actually only going to come down to $29 annually. And then plus the disinfectant and maintenance of cleaning the cartridge, the Derma Roller and the Derma Pen are going to be at somewhat the same level. However, all in all, the Derma Roller is definitely a cheaper choice. We know that hair regrowth is a marathon. It's not something that you do one day and then forget about the next. If you want to tackle hair loss, you're actually gonna have to show up every day, put in the work over a long period of time, actually for as long as you want to keep your hair. So I do think it's worth an investment for sure, but is it worth that difference? I mean, at the end of the day, it comes down to price. Are you willing to have a big upfront cost for this, not knowing exactly how it works? Or would you want to try something cheaper, but essentially does the same thing? I think if I found myself in the predicament to choose whether or not I should go for a Derma Roller, Derma Stamp, a Derma Pen, I think I would honestly start with a Derma Roller if I hadn't used any of them before. I would try it out and experiment with it for a couple of months. If I then decided that I wanted to actually continue to use a microneedling system, I would go for a Derma Pen. Because I think the Derma Pen has more benefits to it than the Derma Roller. You can adjust the depth of the needle. It's much more localized to where you actually want to penetrate the skin, which I noticed with the Derma Pen over the Derma Roller. I think if you master both the Derma Roller and the Derma Pen is still gonna be quicker to do. And on top of that, there are a lot of Derma Rollers out there which are fake, which are faulty and not made precise, which means they can actually have a lot of damage to your scalp. And comparing that with a brand like Dr. Pen, what they have a unique code for each product that you can scratch and search on their website to verify that the Dr. Pen that you're using is actually a real, authentic Dr. Pen certified product, which you can't do with Derma Rollers. So I mean, rather be safe than sorry. Please comment down below which one you would choose. All right, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you found it somewhat useful, and I shall see you in the next one. All right, bye.